Last year, in an interview, you described your sound as Costco rock. Do you stand by it? Are you onto a different superstore this year in terms of the sonic descriptors? Oh, Ardennes rock.
That's cheap. We're not cheap.
Okay.
Costco sells everything, and it's in large quantities, and you can get free samples, and the staff are great.
Yeah, we get free samples.
And I worked there, you know, so I have first-hand experience.
She was a good bagger.
No.
Not bagger, till person?
It's a cashier.
Okay.
Till person. He's a pervert.
I don't know if I'm in a raw onion kind of mood.
Yeah, we'll have a fragrant hangout.
Do you want to try like a rosemary garlic?
Sure.
That sounds nice. It makes me feel like I'm in Canada.
Here it comes. So basically, we're three Canadians in New York trying to reclaim our little bit of heritage that we have, which is poutine. It's not even our heritage because none of us are from Quebec.
No.
No, I know.
Should we just do a poutine swirl?
We've got poutine. Poutine coming through. This is a Canadian treat. Poutine, you want to smell? Yeah, smell?
Oh my god, poutine.
We're here with two of you. There's two others in the band.
Yeah, mm-hmm. They weren't allowed to come.
This is your second full-length record. Mm-hmm. It's called Wide Open. I feel like I heard I a lot more on this record. Mm-hmm. Did you set out to write an album that's much more personal?
Yeah, it was funny because we were talking about this.
I was like, you know every song starts with the word I.
But I said because the last album I would say you a lot, or I would use a metaphor,
right,
and not necessarily like put the onus on myself to just say, oh, this is how I'm feeling, or this is my experience within this context. And also it's fun, I don't know, if you learn a song, there's a pitch and minus, if you learn a song, isn't it fun to like, okay, like Slick, for example, because you can look at the mirror by yourself and be like, hey, my hair is slick back. So it's fun for the listener to sort of like use I as I.
Well, I can be a universal experience.
Yes, I
for
is
sure.
We.
Yeah, I is we.
Namaste.
There's things in the media and the news where it's like, what guys really have to do is they have to like listen to women when they talk about how they're moving through the world and their experiences. So like, what's your relationship to Jasmine's ideas?
I don't know. I'm just a fan, so I get to help be a fan of the music and then help try to elevate it if I can.
Yeah.
And I like the idea of, with this record, taking on like classic rock tropes and like a road record, but from a female perspective. Mm-hmm. I was happy to kind of get out of the way sometimes to allow the emotions to be the biggest thing rather than like pyrotechnics, and then saving those pyrotechnics like for like moments where it really mattered. This is kind of, this is a Jasmine record.
Honestly, I go into the jam space when I have anxiety. I'll be like, okay, it's time to write. I'm feeling on the edge. It's all done kind of fast. At the same time, I'm like trying not to overthink it. Because I think if I had to go back to lyrics and like think of a clever way to explain like my thighs are too big, then that wouldn't work, right? My thighs are too big, my head isn't
small, my brain is on fire. Can we talk about Scream?
Yeah.
First of all, what is the song about?
I feel like people are feeling lost.
Yeah.
They don't have jobs. They don't know, like, they're having a hard time with relationships. It's like the early 2000s. It's just a weird time to grow up, you know?
But that song's like, you know, forget about all that, it's about yourself.
Yeah, kind of like, that's what I mean. Like in the chorus, it's like, but scream your name and have confidence.
The song also features Tanya Tagaq, which is like kind of an insane and perfect.
Love her.
Like it's perfect.
Yeah, she's so cool. She just like came in with a salad. She's like, hey, what's up? And then like takes off her shoes, does two takes.
And the speakers are like,
like I was, we were sitting upstairs like, just like in your soul, you can feel it.
Yeah. you put out your record last year. Mm-hmm. Now you're putting this record out, and everyone's like, oh my God, just a year later. People don't think about it when it's a rapper.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But for some reason, when there's guitars involved, yeah,
they're like, what? I know, it's interesting.
Didn't the Beatles like put out like 2 records a year? And
yeah,
they were all classic?
Every 6 months. But I know, it's like there's no mixtape culture in rock music, so people don't just like, it's more, yeah, because it's like, it's so precious, or so, it's like, I feel like we're pretty serious about like, you know, the actual production of the songs. Oh, yeah. And that, like, there's a lot of work that goes into that, and at the same time, we want to put out things that we are proud of and that are hopefully better than our first album, but we're always going to be kind of goofy, I think. Our band's, like, kind of nuts. The other guys aren't here, but they can... You know, we're fun.
We're fun.
We're fun. We're so fun.
Okay, let's cheers our...
To Canadian health. Poutine!
Hey.
It's good. It's cold because of film production.
Mm-hmm.
Takes a long
time. Let's break the wall here.
Let's break the wall.
And just acknowledge that
there's no magic. It's old, cold, and bold.